My name is Natalia and I'm working with English-speaking couples from different countries like England, United States of America, Czech Republic, Finland, and also not typically English-speaking countries, but also Brazil, Australia, Portuguese, and many others. I was assisting programs for near 30 couples and have observed births of near 50 babies. First couple I was coordinating was from Brazil. They already had daughter. She was 10 years old and they came to Ukraine during winter, so she has never seen snow and weather like this. Since she came out from the airport, she started touching snow and all people were looking at us, but it was really cute. We all understand that this decision is really, really complicated and serious for every couple. And also they all know a lot of information about legal side of the program, but still it's a stressful situation for them too, to come to Ukraine, to meet us, to go to the doctor and to say again about their problem and impossibility to have a baby. And also one of really stressful situations is meeting with surrogate mother. It's also stressful for them too, not only for this lady. Every day we are answering hundreds of questions and surely we have some of them really funny for us, but still we understand that couples are really interested in every detail of the program. So we receive requests like, can we choose exact features of the face of the future baby, like shape of nose, eye color, hair color? And we are answering that unfortunately it's not okay now and this option is not available till now, but maybe in the future we can do this too. And also, for example, like we really want twins. And if one embryo is implanted, can we add one more embryo? So we just understand their opinion and their wish, but unfortunately from medical point of view, it's impossible. I remember the story of one couple because I was dreaming about twins, one boy and one girl. And then during stimulation, we have only two egg cells. Both of them become embryos. And as a result, we have twins born and couple was really, really happy. It was a surprise, but really pleasant surprise only because usually we need at least 10 egg cells to have from them few good quality embryos, and this was only 2 egg cells, 2 embryos and 2 babies born as a result. Every couple is really stressful and nervous before baby birth, but I always say that it's the last days you slept enough and have some time for yourself before the baby is born. Biological mothers can be present during childbirth in most cases, and father will also see the cute little scene from the first minutes of the life. But still, their emotions are really, really unpredictable. Even after waiting for their baby for a long time, some of them start crying and didn't know how to react on the birth of the baby. Some of them need some time to understand that they are already parents and they need to take care after the baby and to do these responsible tasks. But still mostly these tears of happiness are the best moment in their lives. Every time baby is coughing or sneezing, it's a big tragedy for them and they need immediate assistance. So we are answering calls and messages even at night, so it's okay for us too. When program comes to the finish and couple is going back home, it doesn't mean that we stop all communication and didn't keep in touch for the questions and assistance. We continue our help with documents if required, and surely we still receive cute photos from vacation and observe the growth of the baby. And 2 days ago, I received photos of the baby, and this boy is already 3 years old, and I just remember photos from maternity hospital once this baby was born. The most difficult thing is to inform couples not really pleasant news. For example, we receive a scan result and we should inform that pregnancy stopped or our attempt was failed. And this time we are really, really sad, same as couples. We are explaining and supporting couples and say that it's not the end, and we need to try more together for the best result. If I would have possibility to talk with every infertile couple, I would recommend them, please don't be afraid, come to see us, and just remember, there is no situation without no way out.